Hello everybody, today I am again there with you with the concept total surface area and curved surface area of curve. Okay, so today's first problem is a bus stop is barricaded from the remaining part of the road by using 50 hollow cones made of recycled cardboard. Each one has a base diameter of 40 cm and height 1 meter. If outer side of each of the cone is to be painted and the cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square, what will be the cost of painting all these cones? Okay, so now here value of pi is given and root under root 1.04, the two values are given. Okay, this we have to use. So before that, we have to understand, we must understand the problem, then only we can solve this. Okay, so once again I am reading this and then you will mention whatever given things are. Okay, so see here, the bus stop is barricaded from the remaining part of the road by using 50 hollow cones. Okay, how many cones are there? 50 hollow cones. Okay, made of recycled cardboard. Each one has a base diameter 40 cm. Base diameter is given 40 cm. Okay, so that I am taking base diameter is equal to 40 cm. Okay, and what is given? See, and height 1 meter. Height is equals to h equals to 1 meter. Understood? This is given in centimeter, this is given in meter. So we have to make the units here. Okay. If outer side of each of the cone is to be painted and the cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square. Okay, outer side we have to find out. Okay, cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square. What will be the cost of painting all these cones? Okay, cost is given 12 rupees per meter square. Okay, so height is given in meter. We need to convert base diameter into meter. Understood? So that is radius. What will be the radius of this? Radius will be 20 cm. Okay, 20 cm. And in meter, radius is equal to, we will divide here by 100, then it will be 0.20 meters. Okay, so that will be the radius. Now this is also in meter and this is also in meter. Understood? So now what we have to do? Here we have to find out curved surface area. Okay, like that cone is there. So, and it is what they have told us, of recycled cardboard, each one has base diameter 40 cm and height 1 meter. If outer side of each of the cone is to be painted, outer side of each of the cone is to be painted, and the cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square. Okay, outer side is here we have to find out CSA, curved surface area of cone. Okay, but to find out curved surface area, we use formula pi r l. Which formula we use? Pi r l. Radius we have, but length we don't have. That is, slanting height we don't have. So slanting height we need to find out. Okay, so you know that slanting height l is equal to under root r square plus h square. R we have and h also we have. With the help of these two things, we have to find out L. So, L is equals to under root, R is 0.02 square plus H is 1 square. Okay. So, 0.2 square will be 0.2 into 0.2. It will be 0.04 plus 1 square will be 1. Okay. So, now addition of these two will be 1.04. Okay, and here it is given, see, root 1.04 is equals to 1.02. Square root of it is given 1.02. So that will be our slanting height. So L we have now. Understood? Now we can find out curved surface area. Okay, so CSA of a cone. How many cones are there? Like that, there are 50 cones. And the cost is given rupees 12 per meter square. So first we need to find out here curved surface area of one. Okay. So CSA, curved surface area of a cone, is equals to pi r l. Okay. Value of pi is given 3.14 multiplied by radius is 0.2 multiplied by slanting height is 1.0. This product will give you the curved surface area of 1, but that is not our final answer. Okay, so what we need to do after this, there are 50 poles. Okay, this is the curved surface area of one pole. And there are how many poles? 50 poles are there. So here we need to multiply by 50, that is first thing. And cost of per meter square is given rupees 12. So again we need to multiply by 12. So at the same time we can multiply all. Otherwise you can find out this product and then we can multiply by 50 into 12. Understood? So here I am doing the final answer directly. I am doing that 3.14. So what is the question? See, what will be the cost of painting all these poles? So cost of painting is equals to 3.14 multiplied by 0.2 multiplied by 1.02. Okay, what is the cost? Rupees 12 per meter square. This will come in meter square because already we have converted this radius into meter. So definitely this is going to come in meter square. So multiply by 12. How many cones are there? They have told us 50 cones. So we will multiply by here 50. Okay. And the whole product you will get is 384.33 rupees. 384.33 paise. Okay, so this is our final answer. Understood? Question is very simple. In this case, we need to find out curved surface area. That time slanting height, that is L, is important. With the help of radius and height, we have to find out first slanting height, and with the help of slanting height, we have to find out curved surface area. Price is given. Okay, and area is total cones. How many cones are there? That is also given. So we need to multiply by that. So that will be your final answer. Okay, so our answer is rupees 384.30. Okay. Hello everybody. See here, our next problem is, what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make a conical tail of height 8 meter and base radius 6 meter? Assume that the extra material will be required for stitching margins and wastage in cutting is approximately 20 centimeters. Okay, so here first we will see what is given. Okay, so what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide, okay, width is given 3 meter, will be required to make a conical tail of height 8 meter. Height is also given 8 meter, vertical height, this is vertical height. And base radius 6 meter, the radius is also given directly. Okay, now assume that the extra material will be required for stitching margins and wastage in cutting is approximately 20 cm. Means this is extra material is required, 20 cm. That we need to add up to this, okay, in the final answer. Suppose these two statements are important. What length? Here we have to find out length. Okay, width is given. Understood? So length into width is equal to area. Curved surface area we need to find out. Why curved surface area? See, a conical tail. Tarpaulin means it will be open from the bottom. So here we are going to find out curved surface area. Okay. To find out curved surface area, we are going to use formula pi r. Okay. But here height is given. Height is given. L is not given directly. L we need to find out. Slant height we need to find out. So height is given and radius is given. Okay. So with the help of these two, we are going to find out slanting height. So what is given? Height. That is h is equals to 8 meter, and what is given? The radius. Radius of the tail, that is small r, is equal to 6 meters. These two things are given. Okay, with the help of these two, we can find out easily slant height. So slant height is equals to under root h square plus r square. Okay, so what is h? H is 8 square plus r is 6 square. Okay, so 8 square is 64. Plus 36, so that will be 64 plus 36 will be 100 is equal to 10 meters. Okay, so slant height we have now 10 meters. Understood? Now we have slant height, we have radius, so we can find out easily curved surface area. Then we will come to know how much material is required for tail. Understood?
So here we find out per surface area CAC of 10 or pore also we can say is equal to par r 10. Okay. So what is pi? Pi is given 3.14. So that I am taking here 3.14 multiply by radius. What is the radius? 6 meter multiply by length. Slanting height is 10. Okay. So that I am taking here 10. Understood. So when you multiply by 10, that time how will be 31.4 multiplied by 6. So you can find out here final answers. Okay, so per surface area we got 31.4 multiplied by 6. Okay, but now here what is given? Width is given. Width is 3 meter. Width is 3 meter, and we have to find out length. Okay, so we know that length into width is equal to area per surface area here. Okay, so directly we can use length is equal to. Length is equal to 31.4 multiplied by 6 divided by 3. Okay, so now here 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So what you will get? 4, 2 fours are 8, 2 ones are 2, and 3 twos are 6. Okay, so 62.8 meters. This much, this will be the length of that parabola. Understood? But now here one more thing is given. One more thing is given, that is 20 cm is required, work material is required. So that material we need to add here. Okay. So 62.8 plus 20 cm, that we need to convert into meters. Okay. So 20 cm is equal to 20 cm, 20 by 100 meters. So it will be 0.2 meters. So this 0.2 meters we need to add here. Okay. So final total length is equal to 62.8 plus 0.2, so that will be 63 meters. So that is the final answer. Once again, see here what was given. What length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make a conical tent of height 8 meter, base radius 6 meter. The height was given and radius was given. So with the help of that, we have to find out slant height. With the help of slant height, we have to find out curved surface area. And then per surface area, with the help of this given width, we have to find out length. But one more thing was given, that is more material is required, 20 cm, that is margin. So that we need to convert into meters, and that we have to add. So that is 63 meters. Okay. So this is our final answer. Here we need to take care of units. Okay. Sometimes meters we need to convert into centimeters. Centimeters we need to convert into meters. It is depend on the problem. Thank you. Each as written in the here, a cylinder and a cone have equal radius. There are two figures, a cylinder and a cone. Two three-dimensional figures are there. Cylinder and cone have equal radius of their bases. Equal radius of their bases. Okay. So this is cylinder and this is right circular cone, right circular cylinder and right circular cone. Okay, what they have told us, their bases, radii of their bases are equal. Okay, with this radius and this radius of bases are equal. So this suppose you will say r, then here this also small. Okay, radius, radii are equal. One more thing they have told us, height is also equal. Heights of both the figures are equal. With this height, suppose I will take this is h, or here also we can say this distance is h. So here height means this is vertical height, this is h, and both heights are equal. Okay, this is given thing. Now what they have told us, if their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8:5, curved surface area of this and curved surface area of this. Okay, means ratio is given 8:5. Okay, so here we can use curved surface area of cylinder is equal to 2 pi r h. Okay, we use this formula to find out curved surface area of cylinder. Okay, now second thing, that is cone. So curved surface area, or we can write in short CAC also, curved surface area of cone is equal to pi r l. Okay, and the ratio of this is given, 2 pi r h and pi r h. This ratio is given. So directly I can write here, according to the given information, 2 pi r h divided by pi r n. Okay, what is given here? Ratio 8 is to 5, so is equal to 8 upon 5 meter. Okay, so now here height pi, value of pi is going to remain same, radius is same for both the figures. Okay, so these two things we can cancel. Now what these two we can take that side and we can divide. So what is going to remain here? H upon L is equal to 8 by 5 multiplied by 1 by 2. Okay, 2 by 2 here we need to divide. So now here 2 ones are 2, 4 are 8. So what is remaining here? H upon L is equal to 4 upon 5. Okay, so now here we can put here value of L. Okay, what is L? L is the slant height, and slant height is equal to under root x square plus r square. So here I am going to put now. Okay, so h upon value of L is equal to under root h square plus r square. H square plus r square. Slant height is equal to under root h square. S means h means what? Vertical height, and r is the radius. It is equal to 8 4 by 5. Okay, that is going to remain same. Understood? Why we have here we have taken value? Because this L we are going to change in terms of h. Okay, then only we can find out this value. So here we got h upon under root h square plus r square is equal to 4 by 5. Now I want to cancel this root. So I will take square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. By taking square of both the sides, what I will get here? H square. When I will take square of this, that time I will get here only h square plus r square will remain is equal to 4 square is 16 upon 5 square is 25. Okay, what we have done here? We have taken square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. So here h square, when you will take square of this, square root will vanish, then here it will remain h square plus r square is equal to 4 square is 16 and 5 square is 25. Now here we can take cross multiplication, so 25 h square will be 25 h square, 16 into h square plus 16 into r square. Okay, now this h square term you can take this side, then like terms will come together. So now I am taking this here, 25 h square minus 16 h square is equal to 16 r square. Okay, so now here what is going to remain? 25 minus 16, 9 h square is equal to 16 r square. Okay, now what they are asking? They are asking show that the radius of each is to the height of each as 3 is to 4. Okay, so now what we can do here? H square divided by r square, or r square divided by h square also we can take. So now what I am doing here? This 9 upon this 16 I am taking here, divided by 16 is equal to r square upon h square. 9 divided by 16 and r square divided by h square. If I will remove this square, then what I will get? R upon h is equal to what? 3 by 4. We will take square root of 9 and 16. 9 and 16 are perfect square. So 3 upon 4. So r is to h is equal to what? R is to h is equal to 3 is to 4. And that will be they are asking to show. Okay, 3 is to 4. Okay. Once again, we will put a glance here. What was given? A cylinder and a cone have equal radii. Okay, cylinder and the cone have equal radii. So we have taken that is r, base radius of both. We have taken r, small r, and their heights are also equal. So height we have taken h, here also height is h. Then if their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8 is to 5. Okay, curved surface 2 pi r h and pi r n. Ratio is 0. So we have taken 2 pi r h upon pi r n is equal to 8 by 5. So pi r we can cancel. What is remaining here? H by pi is equal to 8 by 5. By this 2 we can divide that. So here it is remaining 4 by 5. Then we have taken value of L. L is the slanting height. Slanting height is equal to the under roots h square plus r square is equal to 4 by 5. Now we need to cancel this square root. So we have to take square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. So h square divided by h square plus r square is equal to 16 upon 25. By cross multiplication, you will get here 9 h square is equal to 16 h r square, and we have to show here 3 is to 4. Okay, radius is to height. So we have taken 9 by 16 is equal to r square upon h square. When you remove this square, that time